name is Judith. I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. Welcome to my craft room. Today I would like to show you this card, as I promised last week, because I showed it to my fellow demonstrators at on stage, and I promised I would make videos for everybody to remember and maybe see properly what I explained that day. So to make this card, you will need vellum. I chose the white one this time. You will need your ink and stamps, and for this card I used, this is the French version, I used this stamp set that you will soon discover in the spring catalogue. I really love this catalogue. And you just stamp. I like to stamp off just because I'm using, Rococo Rose. And I don't know, I tried it with first generation and second, or stamping off. And this is the colour I preferred. So you just stamp the normal way. Now I'm using Granny Apple Green, and with this colour, I liked to stamp immediately and not stamp off. There you are, and you also have a small leaf which I like to fill the middle. Now, the difficult part of this card is that you will have to wait, because vellum doesn't dry as quickly as cardstock. So what I usually do is I leave it overnight. You could also speed the process with a heat gun. I prefer to wait overnight. But I made another version to show you what you have to do with it. This one was made earlier and it is dry. You will need your piercing mat, and you will need what I call my magic wand, because it can do everything. Now, it doesn't do the cleaning and it doesn't do the cooking, which I don't like to stamp with greasy fingers anyway. What you will have to do is to draw over the stamped image. Now, I can't draw, I'm just hopeless. My horses look like my pigs, and it's really awful, I can't draw. But I can do this, it is very easy. Now, what I would suggest is to start with a very light hand, because you don't want to pierce the paper, do you? So you start with a light hand, and once you've mastered the technique, you can try and go over it again to get a better image. And the image, the size that you will use is this one, the back of it. Now, as you can see, these were made with a more pressure, and this one with a light hand, and you can vary the images. Now, I don't want to bore you with this exercise. This is one I finished, and as you can see, the paper is a bit wonky. I don't know the word in English. Never mind. If you want to make it straight, you can feed it through a laminator, and your paper will be just nice and neat. For this card, because it is vellum, you don't want to add glue on it, because you will see it on the other side. So what I did is I added a few decorations which I will use as a place to hide my adhesives. Now, I want this card to be a thank you card, so in this suite you will also have a die which says merci, whichever country you are in, because this suite is called Parisian Blossom, so the idea is to look like you've been in Paris. Now, I will stick this and come back to you afterwards. Here we are, I'm back with you. To add more decoration and to create more space where I could add adhesive, I chose to add this beautiful ribbon. I just love it. It is petal pink and it has edges made with champagne colour. I just love it. I find it gorgeous. I've lost my adhesive. Here it is. So this is what I will use to adhere it, tear and tape. Now you have to be precise because the width of the adhesive is exactly the same as the width of the ribbon. So it is a problem if you can't, if you have some adhesive hanging off. And so I decided to stick this one right at the bottom, at the top, excuse me. And now I can stick the back on the back of the vellum and be precise so that the ribbon doesn't show underneath. Another decoration that I chose to add is, sorry, is these beautiful rhinestones. They're champagne rhinestones. I don't drink champagne. I love it on my paper and rhinestones and so on. And I just love rhinestones. I do believe, they say diamonds are a girl's best friend. I would say rhinestones are a crafter's best friend, aren't they? I love them because they're not very expensive. They're cheap. But if you add them to a card, it really changes everything, I believe. So there you are. And for this card in particular, it changes the fact that I have more space for my adhesive. So this time I will use mini glue dots, which I will stick right behind the rhinestones. They are a bit bigger than the rhinestones, but because the rhinestones are there, there's a kind of illusion and you don't see them. At least I don't. There you are. I put 5 this time. Gives you more opportunity. And then because I have used this merci at the bottom, it is very nice because I have space at the bottom for my glue dots. And let's not get sticked to them. Here we are. So this is the finished decoration. I will stick it to a card base, which I have cut in petal pink paper. The choice of the colour of your base is important because this is what will reveal what you have drawn underneath. And there you are. This is the finished card. I really like the effect that it makes. I do believe it is a delicate colour. This time I didn't do it here just because I forgot really, but you can also add some decorations. Let me show you with another one. You can add some decorations on your card with your stylus. And just doing this, wrong side, just doing this on your vellum, and then it makes some kind of little gems, which I really like, and which is what I did on this card. There you are. I really hope you like this card. I really hope the demonstrators who have seen me have more information. I hope I will see you soon on Le Petit Papier d'Ilse. I think I still have 2 or 3 videos I will make in English. If you want me to do some more, just tell me. Hope to see you soon. Spend a very crafty day. Bye bye.